Pythagoras theorem. You can see the great mathematician Pythagoras, and let us pay tributes to him with right angle triangles first. With right triangle. In a right triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of squares of the other two sides. This is the Pythagoras theorem. An ancient Indian mathematician, Baudhayan, about 800 years back, 800 BC, of course it is given in Sanskrit, you can read. The diagonal of a rectangle produces by itself the same area as produced by its both sides length and breadth. That is what is the theorem here. Okay. Now, we can understand this, how to prove this practically. The theorem has numerous proofs, possibly most of any mathematical theorem. These are diverse, including both geometric proofs and algebraic proofs, with some dating back thousands of years. The theorem can be generalized in various ways. Now, let us prove it by actual calculation of areas of squares of sides of the right triangle. Let us open up a GeoGebra file for calculation of actual areas of squares drawn on the sides of a right triangle. Right. Here is the file, and of course we don't need the algebraic view of this particular GeoGebra file here. Algebraic view I closed. Here you can see ABC is a right triangle. Its sides are 2.85, 3.58 and 4.57, and the areas are calculated here already. And you see AB square, that is the area of this blue triangle on one of the sides of the right triangle, and another side is green one, that is BC square, 12.82. these are the two squares drawn on the sides making the right angle, and this pink triangle is the area of the triangle, area of the square drawn on the hypotenuse. Now you can check here, sum of squares drawn on the sides is equal to the square drawn on the hypotenuse. See, I am changing the measurements, still the same is the calculation here. Whatever is the measure of the hypotenuse or the sides, the areas of sum of the areas is equal to the area of the square drawn on the hypotenuse. AB square plus BC square equal to AC square. That is what is proved here by actual calculation. Let us now prove the theorem in one more method, in another method. Let us see, one more method I have got here. I am going to open another Here I have taken a right triangle. You can see the brown color triangle color. Now, a square is drawn on one of the sides making the right angle. Another square is drawn. Now, third square on the hypotenuse I have drawn. Now, you have to keep these two squares on this square to find whether the sum of whether this area plus this area equal to this area or not. You may not get the immediate answer whether it is true or false. For that, you have to cut this one into pieces and put here. That cutting also we can do, that how to cut this, we can have a particular this one, particular method for that. Draw parallel lines to the sides here, to sets of sides of this hypotenuse, to this side and to this side also, passing through the corners here, the passing through the vertices here of the other square drawn on the one of the sides like this. So this is the parallel drawn to this side and this side, passing through this vertex, and this line is a parallel drawn to this side, passing through this vertex here. These two lines drawn are making this particular brown area, brown square, into four different parts. One, part two I colored blue, three pink color, four I put yellow color. Now I remove the lines here. Now I made into parts. Let me put these parts in this one and find whether this area can be filled by all these four and this one. I am going to put this one, green colored one I brought here. Okay, now the second one, second square I am bringing here, the blue colored, and now the yellow colored one I put it there. Only it is mere arrangement of all these pieces, still there is gap for the red square, and it is also exactly matching there. Is it exactly matching? So both the areas, these two areas are
yes sir,
this area. Is it not? It is paper cutting and pasting activity. Of course I did it on the computer. You can do it using color paper and paste it like this and show to you. Okay, this is one of the activities which proves the Pythagoras theorem. So the area of the square drawn on hypotenuse is equal to the sum of squares drawn on the sides here. You can see very well. Now adjusted, no? Everything adjusted. Okay, another method of proving the theorem is like this. Now what did I do here? I took right angle triangles, four triangles of the same measurement, that means four congruent right triangles I have taken here, and I am trying to place them like this. First triangle I put, and second triangle I will rotate it like this and bring it here. Try to make it, is all trial and error of course, children. Now the next triangle I rotated and I am pasting it here. Now the fourth triangle I put like this and bring it this way. Now you see all the four triangles I arranged them into a square here, where the outside square, suppose if you think that the lengths of sides small a, small b and small c, then the length of outer square here, the side of outer square will be, this is b and this is a plus b, this is a, this is b, a plus b, again this is a, this is b, a plus b, again this is a and this is b, a plus b. So a plus b is the side of the outer square, c is the side of the inner square, hypotenuse is there here, this side, this side, this side, all the equal to hypotenuse. So inner square has a side c units, outer square has a side a plus b units. Now let us put the statement here. What is the statement here? Now if you want to take the outer square, inner square area, from the outer square area you have to subtract 4 times of area of one triangle you have to take, because all the four triangles are congruent to each other. So one area of one triangle into 4 will give you area of all the four triangles. From the outer square if you subtract the areas of four triangles, you will get the area of the inner square. So let us write the equation for this one. Outer square area a plus b whole square, inner square area c square. So c square equal to outer square area a plus b whole square minus 4 multiplied by half base into height. Base and height will be the sides forming the right angle in a right triangle. So half a into b, 2 into 2, 2's are 4, so 2 divides this 4 2 times, 2 into ab, 2ab here, minus 2ab plus 2ab getting cancelled here, and a square plus b square is remaining. So c square, that is hypotenuse square, is equal to sum of squares on the sides a square plus b square. So again Pythagoras theorem is proved by this method. We learn this. Yes. Tell me. More method. Oh my god, this is the fourth one now. Of course we have seen already three. Another method now. We can draw semicircles on the sides of a right angle triangle. Even the areas of semicircles, suppose when you compare, the area of the semicircle drawn on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of areas of semicircles drawn on its sides. Area of the semicircle on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of areas of semicircles drawn on its sides. Okay, you can very well see the calculation here. Sum of the areas 4.52 plus 8.7 is equal to 13.23. You can very well see the measurements here and the calculation here. Will it happen only to this triangle? Is equal to some area of the semicircle on the hypotenuse. So we can very well put this in the general form this way. Semicircle, area of semicircle is pi r square by 2. Here, radius of each semicircle is nothing but half of the side here. Half of the side here. So, pi c by 2 whole square. This is c if you take. This one is c, this is b, this is a. So, a by 2 whole square plus pi b by 2 whole square. Because this is b, half of it is only radius. This is the diameter. Diameter by 2 we have to take. So here pi is can be taken common here, cancelled. C square by 4 equal to a square by 4 plus b square by 4. 4 can be cancelled. C square equal to a square plus b square. This is the theorem here. So it can be proved. Pythagoras theorem can be proved using semicircles also on the drawn on the sides of a right triangle. Now I am going to close this here. Logical proof. So how do you prove logically? Let us see this particular file and come back quickly to find out what is given in our textbook and do this. We have triangle ABC right angle at B. To prove Pythagoras theorem logically, we draw BD perpendicular to AC. BD perpendicular to AC we will draw. BD makes triangle ABC into two right triangles, and each of the right triangle is similar to the bigger triangle ABC. This you have to keep in mind. Okay, now we shall go back, find what is given. So for proving the theorem we need 5 parts. 1, the statement and the corresponding figure. Here is the statement and the corresponding figure. What is given? Given is right triangle ABC, and the right angle is at B in this. And we have to prove that the hypotenuse, that is the side opposite to right angle AC whole square, is equal to sum of squares on the sides, that is AB square plus BC square. We have to prove. For that, construction is there, that is the fourth part. We have to draw BD perpendicular to A. Perpendicular is shown here. Now the same I am taking here, the figure I has taken to give the proof, that is the fifth part of the theorem. We'll take one of the triangles ADB, which is made by drawing the perpendicular from right vertex of the right angle to the hypotenuse BD, and this to compare this one, I want to put this aside in the same way how it is made. I am putting it here now. I cut here and put it here. What did I do? First it was there, I cut it and put it here. Understand? Now we can compare very well. Here ABC is equal to ADB, and angle A here is angle here also. So therefore two angles are correspondingly equal in these two triangles. Therefore these two triangles are similar by AA similarity. So here you can understand ABC is equal to ADB. The angles are equal, each is 90 degrees by construction. Therefore A is a common angle. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB by AA similarity. And therefore, in two similar triangles, the sides are in the same ratio. I am comparing like this. AB by AD is equal to BC by DB is equal to AC by AB. Now, you need AB square is equal to something here, that is to be proved. So, here AB is there, here AB is there. The same side here and here is there. So we will avoid the the middle ratio and write only these two ratios here. Take AB by AD is equal to AC by AB. Thereby, you can take the cross product as AB square is equal to AD into AC. This one you remember as the first equation, equation number 1. Yes. Now, the next, this one. Now, let us compare ABC and BDC. You may ask me how to remember. In the first case, we went like this from A and we went to B. A, D, B. We went to B like this. Now, in the second case, we went up to the hill, you think. Come down the hill now. Come down the hill from B to C, you go this time. Go like this up, come like this down. This way up, this way down. So, now second time we are taking BDC as the triangle to compare. The second triangle I am comparing with the bigger triangle. In these two triangles, now let me see that particular part. Let us cut it from the this one. I colored it first. Cut it, put it here. Okay. Now we can compare easily. This is BDC, triangle BDC. And BDC in these two, ABC is equal to BDC, each is 90 degrees by construction, and angle C is common in both. Therefore, by AA similarity, these two triangles are similar. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC. In two similar triangles, the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Therefore, we will write the ratios like this. AB by BD, this side by this side, this side by this side, is equal to BC, this side by corresponding side DC, is equal to AC by BC here. Now we need BC square, so BC is coming in these two ratios, so we avoid this ratio because we don't need it. Okay, let us take BC by DC is equal to AC by BC. Now the cross multiplication, you can take the product BC square is equal to DC into AC. This is the second equation we need to prove the theorem. First one, AB square is equal to AD into AC, and the second one, BC square is equal to DC into AC. Now when you add these two in the RHS, you have AD into AC plus DC into AC. Here in the LHS, AB square plus BC square is there, let it be. And in these two, AC is a common factor. I took it as a common here, and I can write these two in the brackets now. AD plus BC into AC. And AD plus DC, is it not equal to AC? Yes. So it is AC,
yes, sir,
into AC. So nothing but AC square. Therefore, we can give the proof very well. AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square here. And now the theorem is proved logically also.